As the Spa event comes to an end, another gets underway at Monza, the most eagerly awaited race of the year for Ferrari and its fans. Stefano Domenicali, Scuderia Ferrari team principal, analyzes the rapid change of scene from Belgium to Italy and reveals his feelings going into the home race.
In the usual message to the Scuderia, you have used three words, disappointment, awareness and relief, to describe the result of the Belgian Grand Prix. Why did you make this choice?
Because I believe that this represents the synthesis of the race of Spa. Disappointment from the sporting point of view, the result could have been totally different, of course. I believe that considering how the race has developed, we could have collected the very important points for the classification. Relief, because considering what happened, it would have been a very serious damage or a serious injury for Fernando. And the relief is to see him that he's fine with no problem at all. And awareness is related to the fact that the championship is still on our hands, in the hands of the people of Maranello, that has to show how they have to improve the car, because it's not at the level that they should be. So the awareness of the fact that we don't have to look back, the awareness of the fact that the competition is very, very open, and Fernando is still leading the championship. So this is the basis from which we need to look ahead.
On the positive side, there was the performance of Felipe on Sunday. How do you evaluate the behavior of the Brazilian driver?
I'm very happy for Felipe. That was a race that we needed as a team, he needed as a driver. After a very difficult Saturday in qualifying, I think that in the race he shows a very strong pace. And this is what we need already next Sunday in Monza, but also in the next races up to the end of the season.
Fernando came back to Maranello with the team. How did you find him the morning after in Maranello?
It was all right. It was okay, no problem, no pain. Totally focused and motivated for Monza.
And how about the reaction of the team?
I would say the same. After the return on Sunday night together in the charter to Bologna, there was a lot of disappointment, as you can imagine. But I would say that it's already a couple of days that the spirit is totally, you know, positive, and everyone is looking forward for the race.
In these circumstances, is it good that you can come back racing immediately?
I would say so. I think it's important to react immediately to go on the track. The more you wait, and the more the time maybe is consuming you. So I would say that in this case, it's really good that we are back in the next couple of days in Monza.
Now we go to Monza. Is it a special race for Ferrari, or is it just one of the 20 races of the season?
I would say that it's the mix of the two. It's a special race because we go in our home Grand Prix with special feelings. But the points that everyone is scoring in Monza are the same that the ones that you score all around the world. So I would say that we really hope that we can have very important points in a very important Grand Prix for us.
How do you see this race from the technical point of view?
It will be very challenging. We know that the configuration that all the teams will use in Monza will be one-off, because you will not use it anymore. So we know that there are some other teams that are very, very competitive in this kind of nature, this kind of track. But we need to go there with the optimism to try to make sure that we can do a good result.
The Autódromo will be, as usual, full of Ferrari flags. Do you think they can give an extra boost, some more horsepower?
I think that for sure the extra boost will come from the emotion that they will be able to transfer to the team and to the drivers. The more horsepower they will be able to deliver to us, and the better they will be. But for sure they will do the maximum, and it will be on our hand to try to recompensate them with all the support they're giving to us.
Do you feel comfortable to make a prediction for the race?
I never do a prediction. For sure, what I really hope is to react straight away after the race that we finished in Belgium, and to come back from Monza with very important points.
The lack of track testing built into the Formula One rules in recent years has given increased importance to simulation work in preparation for the races. A close word to those who don't work there, the Maranello simulator is revealed by Gabriele Delicolli, the engineer who runs the simulator for the race drivers and testers on test days.
With the test reduction that we had in 2006, the simulator usage for a Formula One team became very more attractive than how it could have been in the past. In 2006, we started working using a third-party simulator, and we started also designing our simulator that was completed and installed here in Maranello at the end of 2009. Usually we do have our official driver Fernando and Felipe coming to prepare the race and to help us in validating our car model and helping us in making the simulator more realistic. In particular, they normally come before the race to do some running and test some setup option, and then the Monday or the Tuesday after the race they come again to see if the simulator is very much realistic or not, and indicate and suggest what we have to do to improve the simulation. One activity that we normally do with the official test driver is also the learning for new tracks, because as we know, in the past years many new tracks became part of the championship. So we have we need to get the driver more used to the new track, and also for us we can collect racing lines data to do offline simulation that are essential for all the simulation that we normally do to prepare the race. One other important usage of the simulator is with the young drivers that are normally driving for the first time a Formula One car, and we plan an initial day of testing on the simulator to get the new young driver learning and used to the Formula One usage in terms of what they have to do on the car when they're driving, and in this way is easier for them to drive the car, and also is more efficient because they are already somehow used a little bit to the work they have to do on the rear car, and then they can use a better usage of the day of testing that they normally have on the rear car.
Your first experience with a simulator?
Yes, it was in the end of the 2008. And to be honest, my first practice was a bit difficult because the first moment with this big video, I had a bit sickness problem. But and then I get trained, and to be honest, after the second test, I was perfect, and now I feel very well to drive all the simulator.
How much this helps in the job of driver?
For sure, help a lot. For all the procedure that you have in the steering wheel, help a lot because you have less think to do when you do the test, to think just to the car. For sure, it's a bit different, but I think the simulator of now is fantastic.
What is the difference between simulation and track?
The difference, there is a bit for sure when in the acceleration, when you feel the lateral and the longitudinal acceleration is much more for sure in the real. And also you feel a bit more the risk. Except that I think the simulator now is very similar than the car. You can do the same trajectory, you can push as well. So it's very, I think, a good combination for driver to practice the drive.
With the help of the Scuderia Ferrari engineers, in this edition we kick off a new edition of the Formula One alphabet. Today, the meaning of aquaplaning, mapping, par fermé and ratios.
Aquaplaning is a phenomena which a tire is floating on the water film. Then, in that case, car is very, very dangerous stage. So driver can't control the car, nothing to do, because tire has no contact patch with the road. When the rain is coming, so water film exists on the road. Then very high pressure in front of the tire is generating, because car is very, very quick. Then as a result, so water pressure is very high, then tire is floating on the water film. Then how to avoid that phenomena is that one is much more downforce is very, very effective, because fighting to the very high pressure of water to downforce is fighting. Then if they keep the contact patch on the road in rain condition, we can avoid the aquaplaning phenomena.
Defining mapping of an engine is not easy. Mapping is a table of instruction that the engine gets from the electronic units. For example, when the driver push the throttle to a certain position, this table informs the engine which kind of spark advance injection time the engine has to use. This map is prepared in dyno, where for each RPM and each position of the throttle, the engineers decide which is the right spark advance and the right injection timing, and then these are stored in the electronic unit and used in the car when the engine is running.
Par fermé is per the sporting regulation, start with the qualifying from Saturday, so at 2 o'clock in the normal schedule, and finish at the start with the start of the race in a normal schedule at 2 p.m. on Sunday. Normally, considering a normal schedule, start at qualifying at 2, finish at 3, and in 3.5 hours the cars must be covered with the FIA seal as well. The FIA seal and the cover will be removed 5 hours before the start of the race, so 9 o'clock a.m. and then, as I said, open when you start the race. The rule of the par fermé says that you cannot touch the setup of the car, so you basically can just change a few stuff on the driver's comfort. But in case you have a damage on the car, or there is a big shunt, you ask the FIA to do the change, and then you have to replace the parts with the same weight and specific of the part you replaced.
The ratios are the collections of gears which are mounted and fitted into the gearbox. The FIA limit and have some rules to control the design and the mounting of the ratios. They have to be 30 in a season, and they have to be declared at the beginning, the first Thursday of the first race. There is a maximum of forward gear, which has to be 7, and there has to be a reverse gear which has to be always available for the driver in every moment on the track. There are other rules. The gears has to be have a limited width that cannot be less than 12 millimeter. A position which cannot be of the center of the gears, which each other has to be not closer than 85 millimeter, and a weight limit. So they has to be the weight has to be higher than 600 gram. And the purpose of the ratios is to transmit the torque from the engine to the drive shaft. So this is the primary purpose of the gear couples as in a normal production car gearbox. And this is why the engine torque map has a proper shape and to deliver a proper power and to maximize, let's say, the power of the engine, the gearbox and therefore the ratios reduce progressively the torque and meanwhile increase the revs of the wheel to maximize, let's say, the acceleration of the car.
Scuderia Ferrari Racing News will be back on Friday, September 14th, with the Singapore Grand Prix preview and the latest news from Maranello.